Top of the morning, it's your boy, we back. You know what I'm saying? Author Chris Jackson, y'all see the book. So listen, this morning I'm going to tell y'all a story because my Shana and I jumped on this morning on my way back here to do this video. So it's raining real bad, right? So the man was in his house and it started to flood inside his house. So he climbs out the window. He's standing on the window ledge and the water's coming up. So he climbs all the way up to the roof of his house. So he's praying and said, God, I don't want to die like this. Please come save me. Please, Lord, come save me. Now, don't forget. Now, I want y'all to understand that part of the story is that the man is saved. He trusts God. He believes in God. So he said, God, please save me. I don't want to die like this. He didn't want to die. He didn't want to drown. So he's at the apex, at the top of the roof, at the peak of it. He's sitting there. And the guy comes by in a canoe, small canoe boat. Said, hey, man, I can help you get out of rain. He said, no, I'm waiting on the Lord. So then the guy comes by in a speedboat. And says, hey, man, jump on in so before, because the water's almost there. He said, no, I'm waiting on the Lord. So then a guy comes by like in a yacht. Says, hey, man, come on before you're not gonna make it if you don't jump in this yacht. He said, no, I'm waiting on the Lord. So the water's consumed. He drowns. He didn't want to drown. That was his fear, right? So now he makes it to heaven because remember, he trusts and believes in God. So the first question this dude asks, he's like, God, when do you save me? God sat back, you know, God, he's kind of smooth. God got some player stuff y'all know about. I'm telling you, this is how I see him. So God sat back and was like, I sent somebody 3 times. Do y'all grasp what was just said? The problem was we look for certain things from God the way we want them to come. We want them to come according to our understanding, according to our visionary. But a lot of times, God gonna send him a different way. See, before the water even hit him, the canoe was there. When the water started touching him, the speedboat was there. But before he drowned, he sent him a yacht. So in other words, I made it even more comfortable for you. You could have been in a great position. You could have been eating caviar or whatever else. The thing was, you said I'm waiting for God to save you. He's like, I sent somebody 3 times. Don't get mad when stuff ain't going the way you want to go and don't blame God, because what I've come to personally know is this. He can use anybody he chooses to come to you, to tell you, to talk to you. If he wants you to understand something, he wants you to visualize something, God gonna give it to you. How he wants you to know it. He's gonna tell you what he wants you to hear, what he wants you to know through whomsoever it is. Don't judge the person who's bringing a message. Just pay attention to the message. See, the problem is we're so quick. We got a propensity to want to defy whatever the messenger is saying. We want to look at the pastor. We want to look at the evangelist. And we want to look at the people on TV and like, ooh, we too busy focusing on them. It has nothing at all to do with them. The only thing it's about is what God is saying to you. So just because it don't come the way you want it to, don't mean he ain't delivering it. I really want that to sink in this morning because it just jumped all in my shot now when I was on my way. I was like, ooh, my shot. I'm like, ooh, that's good, Lord. Now, I want y'all to know this. I heard this story years ago. Someone told me this. And the crazy part is, he said, you got to quit trying to make God fit you. Basically. Because that's what that was all about. Like, well, if you ain't going to come personally and do this, do that, I'm going to just sit here. Tell me, I'm waiting on the Lord. God, like, you going to drown. Because I done sent to everybody. I done sent them 3 times. You want to drown. You don't want to live. You don't want to live. You want to let it go. Let it just take a better. Let it go. Let it go then. Because that's what you wanted to do. That was your purpose. See, when you got an idea and you really give it up to God, he'll allow things to come into your life and things happen. I'm talking from personal experience. He'll allow things to happen that will help you. The problem was, I took the things he blessed me with and I did what Chris wanted to do. Uh-oh. Watch out, somebody. Y'all better be ready for this. So now that I'm not in the position that I wanted to be in, it ain't got nothing to do with God. It's all my fault. But now he's bringing it back around again, and I see it coming. He's showing it to me clearly and concisely. And Lord, I'm allowing you to see what's going to happen. He said, this time, it's going to be a little more work for you because I handed it right to you on a silver platter. But you didn't grasp it. Let me rephrase it. I grasped it, but I squandered some of it and did what I wanted to do. So it ain't got nothing to do with God. So now you're like, I still know you want this. I still know you want that. But for you to get to where you desire to be, you got to pay attention to what I'm doing. So in other words, God is bringing things into fruition for you. He's making things come to pass. And it's going to bless you. It's going to benefit you. The thing is, quit judging how it comes. Quit judging how it looks. Quit judging who's saying it. Quit judging if it didn't come the way or it's not as grandiose as you think it should be, or if it's not all like super extravagant or this and that, because a lot of times it's that still small voice. Y'all wasn't ready. Y'all wasn't ready for the still small voice. What I'm trying to tell y'all is this, man. Look, listen to what he's saying. Again, quit looking at what's being said, but listen for it. He said, it's in James. I think it's one. I can't think of the verse, but it says in chapter one, it says, slow to wrath, slow to speak, but quick to listen. See, we got two ears for a reason in my mouth. Sometimes you need to shut what's called up and pay attention to what's being conveyed to you. Because a lot of us, we just keep it going. Keep it going. Let it go. Let it go. But listen to what's being conveyed to you, because he's trying to tell you. Now, think about it. He's not trying to tell you something. He's telling you something. God don't have to try. He's going to tell you what he wants you to know. He's being clear with it. He's being concise with it. But you got to learn to receive it. So when the blessings start coming in, and before you go out doing what you want to do, because that's what Chris good for that. He's like, oh, Chris going to go buy him another motorcycle, go do this. Mm-mm. Lord, what do you want me to do with this? Because once you put it in my hands, in my lap, show me how to do this and make it flourish. See, instead of him giving me these talents and I bury them in the ground, take these talents that he gave me, make them useful, make them beneficial, make them a blessing. So again, this your boy. You know we ain't going to be long before y'all. But I really want y'all to let that sink in and tell you, like, hey, quit killing the messenger. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of times God send it right your way. You just concerned with who it came from. Because you do or don't like them, or they think that, who gives a care what they think or how they act? That's not on you. That has nothing to do with you. Listen to what he's telling you. Pay attention to what he's bringing into your life. And then ask him how to use what he's giving you. Ask. Come on, ask. Come on, ask. I'm telling you, ask. He's going to tell you something. Listen, it's your boy. It's the book. I know it's always love. Oh, y'all ain't know I could do the look. Look, the shoulder shake. That was my keys in my pocket, too. The little shoulder shake on y'all. But listen, must be me. It's always love to Nesta, y'all, for sure. Peace.